distribusi partisipasi sendiri saja, teman. It is quite evident that the current global economic condition are still full of uncertainty. In its last issue of April, the IMF World Economic Outlook emphasized that there wouldn't be any significant improvement soon on global economic profile. Not only the report places the issues on prolonged weakening of advanced economies, but it also predicts how emerging economies are now also facing the moderation of their growth expectation. Last month, the Chinese government announced that its economy only grew 7% in the first quarter of 2015. It was not long ago when China still had double-digit growth, and it has been declining quite consistently since then. People really hoped that China wouldn't have a hard landing, because as the second largest economy in the world, the impact would be quite considerable, including for Indonesia, European countries, and Japan are no better than China. More specifically, the growth slowdown also happens in many countries. I just want to share our latest meeting in Baku, Azerbaijan. We had a year-long meeting, and one of the side effects is roundtable of seminar about the commodity price. And in fact, now it's clear that most of the countries suffer due to the low oil price. In fact, maybe only the U.S. feels that the low oil price is good for everybody. But then, after the U.S. comment, everybody else on the table reacted differently. They said, it might be good in the short term, but certainly it's not good for the medium or even longer term. And what we are worried is that this low oil price will make the other commodity price having persistently low price for quite some time. And I don't think the oil price will increase soon enough. I think it will take maybe a year, one more year, or even more to go back, let's say, to the range of a normal oil price at around $80-$90. Of course, we are talking about oil price of $100 or even higher. It is too much. It will be hard for, of course, the important company. So, I just would like to share with you that now the issue of low commodity price already becomes a global issue. And what impressed me is the title of that seminar at the time is not low, it's not about the oil price. We are talking about commodity price. At the first half of discussion, all discussion about the oil price, but the second half, they change topic mostly on the commodity price. Because some countries on the table, they don't even produce a single barrel. But they are coffee producer, tea producer, CPO like us, and other mining products. So, at the end, the solution to the so-called global slowdown will be determined by the volatility of the oil price. So we hope this oil price will go to the better direction rather than staying like what we have right now. Because it really makes the global economy slowing down. So, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, just early this week, our Bureau of Statistics announced our GDP growth of the first quarter of 2015, and as you know, we only had 4.71% growth. This number is in general, of course, lower than expectation of most agencies, including consensus forecasts. As I mentioned earlier in my speech, global economic slowdown has to some extent dragged down our economic performance. But it doesn't mean that our domestic economy is free of problem. Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, the government has always been optimistic, but remains vigilant of various risks and is prepared for different scenarios. We have some measures in place to deal with the worst. In regards to the crisis prevention and solution, the government, together with the other authorities, such as Bank Indonesia, OJK, Financial Service Authority, and Deposit Insurance Company, under the Coordinated Forum for Financial System Stability, have developed a more integrated and coordinated crisis management protocol. MOF us for having more facilities extended by law, now has delivered to broader opposition. Some people have some concern on the very high tax that we target here. I can assure you that the side of credit tax is prepared by the DigiTax. I explained before, we have also prepared some measures for different scenarios. What I can share with you today is the government is and will be working very hard to keep our budget at the same level. Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to reassure you that it is the current administration's main intention to make the best out of Indonesia potential. We are currently working on the new political momentum with the new government in place. It is our commitment, as directed by our president, to work seriously and deliver on the result. I strongly believe that over the next 5 years, more structural reforms will be even further pushed to make Indonesia even more attractive destination for both domestic and international investors.